Hey folks, my name is Lexi Falcone-Letterman, and I'm a Senior Product Manager on the Customer Experience Engineering team. Today, I'd like to introduce to you the Security Operations pillar of the Zero Trust Workshop. While Security Operations is not traditionally recognized as one of the six core pillars of Zero Trust, its role is foundational. Threat protection and response capabilities must be interwoven across all these pillars to ensure a resilient security posture. In this workshop, we've introduced security operations as a standalone pillar to simplify deployment and adoption for security teams. This approach provides clear, actionable guidance in a logical sequence, helping teams operationalize Zero Trust principles more effectively and cohesively. Let's get started. Implementing a Zero Trust strategy can pose many challenges, such as knowing where to start, what order to implement things, and how to accurately measure success towards achieving a secure Zero Trust posture. The Microsoft Zero Trust Workshop aims to tackle these problems and simplify the Zero Trust journey. If you are new to the Zero Trust Workshop, I would recommend first watching our intro video, which will highlight what the workshop is and how it can help your organization develop a secure Zero Trust strategy. To get things started, let's talk about your role in delivering the workshop. While the workshop content helps with the structure, the biggest value customers are going to take away are the insights you provide. Therefore, you're going to need to wear multiple hats. The first hat is as a subject matter expert on the technology itself. You will be the customer's technical advisor for the Defender Suite, as well as Microsoft Sentinel. Not everyone attending will be at the same level, so you might need to educate attendees as you go. Later, we will go into some documentation capabilities of the workshop that will help you refresh your knowledge on each recommendation. The second hat is your experience with the security operations space in the industry. It's your job to highlight the value add of using Microsoft SIEM plus XDR products better together and what it means to adopt Zero Trust principles through these products. Lastly, you also need to be a facilitator. Our experience delivering these workshops is that the workshop itself sparks a lot of valuable conversations, including some real lightbulb moments. Now let's talk about who you should include in the workshop. Enterprise security teams are as diverse as the organizations they protect. Depending on company size, industry, and maturity, a security team might be a large, specialized department or a small group of individuals wearing multiple hats. Regardless of size, the goal remains the same: to protect the organization's data, systems, and people from evolving threats. For this workshop to be effective with customers, we need participation from multiple members of the security team, including the specialists that are experts in their area, and decision makers like IT managers or SecOps managers. We also recommend leadership to join if possible, because we will cover topics that will require their buy-in and support to do things perhaps a little bit differently. Now I'd like to shift and start talking about the actual delivery of the workshop. The SecOps workshop is fully comprehensive and provides a recommended deployment path for the entire Microsoft SIEM plus XDR journey. However, it's important that you get an understanding of where the customer would like to focus. For example, if they've already deployed and adopted Defender for Identity, they may not want to start with that topic, even though it is listed first in our workshop. If they're using a third-party EDR solution, they may not want to spend much time on Defender for Endpoint. It's important to meet the customer where they're at so you can establish a relationship of trust and serve as a trusted advisor on this important subject. We typically recommend that you start with a 2-hour time block for the first remote session. You can then add additional sessions as needed to make sure you cover everything. For on-site workshops, you can block off 5 to 8 hours if possible, because you'll get a lot more back and forth conversations when you're in person. Keep in mind that these time estimates are dynamic and may change as our content evolves. You can visit aka.ms/ZT workshop guide for the most recent time estimates. Now that you have the workshop scheduled, and before you are on the official call with the customer, open the workshop spreadsheet and practice clicking on the dropdowns a couple of times, familiarizing yourself with the different status options. As you'll see, there are many options available in the dropdown menu. We'll be calling out a few of them now. Planned means that the customer hasn't actually started deployment yet. In progress means they're beyond the planning phase and have started deployment. Third party is where you can mark items where the customer is using a third party security product such as CrowdStrike, Palo Alto, or Splunk. And lastly, there are many cases where the customer says, "We're looking into this, but we really need more information or help on the topic." Mark these as a follow-up. This is a great way to indicate topics that need special attention from Microsoft and opens the door for follow-up engagements with either yourself or a different Microsoft resource, depending on the need. Each recommendation has an implementation effort, which measures how much work security teams need to do to deploy a feature or control, and a user impact score, which measures how much the change affects end users, especially non-privileged ones. If you click on the recommendation, you'll be directed to a detailed review of the topic. This includes reasoning for the implementation effort and user impact scores, an overview of the topic, how the topic fits into Zero Trust principles, what happens if the topic is not implemented, and further documentation on the topic. When you go through this SecOps pillar, it's important to keep the topics high level at first to avoid diving into configuration rabbit holes. Remember, the goal of the workshop is to enable customers to log their current Zero Trust progress and develop an actionable roadmap for moving forward, not to provide catered step-by-step guidance for each configuration recommendation. After you complete the workshop exercise, your boxes will look something like this. When you pass this on to the customer, it will give them a roadmap of the areas they need to focus on and give you a list of areas you need to follow up on. Closure is a big deal. When you step back, you've helped the customer build their entire Zero Trust strategy. So we recommend you have a closure meeting for around an hour, ideally with leadership. In this meeting, be sure to summarize the big picture that highlights the good things the customer is doing, especially when leadership is there, as well as the top 3 to 5 things that need to start being worked on. Also, make sure you summarize the next steps for both you and the organization you're working with. This is a great opportunity to recommend more Zero Trust pillars of the workshop and additional projects derived from the workshop. We've seen this as a great vehicle to kickstart ideas for new projects. So there you have it. We've gone through a full overview of the security operations pillar of the Zero Trust workshop. If you'd like to learn more about the Zero Trust workshop and the pillars that we offer, you can visit aka.ms/ZT workshop. Thanks for your time and have a great day.